Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Rebecca and on this channel I go for all things accounting, finance, Excel and investment related. So if you do like this kind of content then please do consider subscribing, and of course let's jump straight onto the computer. So I've actually worked out how to use the settings properly where I can have my webcam below here and viewing the screen at the same time. So what a noob. Let's go to log on. So we're going to look at Vanguard first. And today we're going to have a look at my passive income and different streams for the month of November. And I know it's not the end of November just yet. However, there are quite a few videos coming out onto the channel. So I just want to make sure that I cover this off before the end of November. Now, if I start coughing throughout the course of the video, it's because I have a chest infection at the moment. So we're just trying to get over that, but just bear with me. So let's go ahead and have a look at performance here. So in fact, you can see here that my ISA value is £1,886.08, and my largest current holding is with the Life Strategy 100% equity fund accumulation. So there's £1,175.73 in there. So let's go ahead and look at performance. So down here, we are given a graph which shows you how your investment's grown or gone down in any given period. But if we go to calculations up here, we can see the total amount of cash that has been paid in and the current investment value gain or loss in that period, as well as any charges. So you can see there that 72 pence was charges, hence why it's shown in a negative there. So if we go down to month, we just scroll down a little bit. What we can see here is that in November we've made a loss at the moment of £12.53. So that's given us cumulative returns to date of £86.08. And if we look at October, we actually made a gain of £35.27. So in the month of November, I actually put in £600 into my investments as opposed to the usual £100 that you can see going down there. So if we go to investments now, let's look at what's happened in the month. So I'm showing a rate of return of 11.77% at the moment. And if we look at the FTSE 100 index units trust accumulation, there's £400 in there at the moment. And that's provided me with a gross return of 8.41% and a total gain of £15.30. Now, in prior months, I've also had this Life Strategy 100% equity fund accumulation. And in there, you can see I've got £1,099.24, which is a slight jump to what we had in last month because of the investment that I've made in this current month. So you can see there that overall gross return is 13.32%. So total gain of £76.47, which is not bad at all. Now, I've made two new investments this month, and one of those is the S&P 500. So that's almost the equivalent of the FTSE 100 that we've got in the UK. So it's the top 500 companies in the USA. So you can see that I purchased £266.39. And actually, there has been a gross loss of 1.63% in November. So total loss has been £4.34. And if we look at the Global Equity Fund Accumulation, which is again a new fund that I've invested in, and I only invested £30 in one, big spender, you can see there that I've actually made a loss of 2.09% or 63 pence. Now, what I will say is that I'm not worried about these losses that I've got in the period because, as you know, my type of investment is long term, so I'm not after short term gains. So I do know that, for instance, the S&P 500 has grown over the past 10 years. Same with the likes of the FTSE 100, etc. And there are always going to be dips in the market. But again, my strategy is not to make any quick decisions there. So I am going to keep those investments in the S&P 500 and the Global Equity Fund Accumulation. And I think it's also important to show that sometimes you will make a loss. We want to be realistic on this channel. So there we have it there. Now, if we go to Insight over here, we can see the geographical regions where we've got those investments. So the top 8 geographical regions are Europe, North America, the UK, Asia Pacific, Japan, and we've also got some in Middle East Africa now and a lot in other, so 16% in other. And if we go further down, you can see here that my top 10 investments are in the FTSE UK Share Index Unit Trust. I have 12.1% in the Vanguard US Equity Index Mutual Fund, 12% in Vanguard FTSE Developed World ex-UK Equity Index Fund. And then there's others. I'm not going to read all of them for you. So you can just take a look on the screen there. And if you look at sector allocation, I have a lot in financials, information technology, consumer, healthcare, industrials, consumer staples. So again, the way that I sort of invest is to obtain a very diversified portfolio. I don't just want to invest in, say, you know, one particular stock necessarily. I want to be able to spread that across different regions and different sectors, as you can see here. And if you want to look at product type, you can see up here that I've got 62% in blended, 37% in equity, and 0% in cash. And if you want to learn more about the type of investments I'm holding here, so again, if I go to holdings, then if you go onto the Vanguard website, it does tell you a little bit about each one of those investments, or I can cover that again in another video. That's Vanguard. So let's have a look quickly at trading 212, because again, I've made a few changes this month. So we'll just log on here. Okay, you can see here that I now have 7 investments inside this trading 212 account. And if I just scroll down here, it's just a bit easier to see. So I now have a whopping £35.45 in Amazon, £42.33 in A&I Pharmaceuticals, £168.62 in AstraZeneca, £14.53 in iShares Global Clean Energy, £83.60 in Robinhood, £194.53 in Tesla, and then I also have shares again in Vanguard S&P 500 in trading 212. So overall, I have 7 investments with a portfolio of £791.50. And you can see, if we just scroll back up here, that in the month, you can see the spikes there where I've made an investment here and here. So at the moment, you can see that I'm currently making a small loss compared to the investment I originally made in A&I Pharmaceuticals. The same with iShares Global Clean Energy, same with Robinhood, and again, same with Vanguard S&P 500. But again, not worried about it. I'm just going to keep those shares in there and see how they perform long term. Now, if you want to start with trading 212, you can actually use this code here that I've got below. So that's just on screen right now. So if you actually use this code when you sign up to trading 212, then you get a free stock and I get a free stock. So it's definitely worth using that referral code if you're going to be using trading 212. Now, if we have a look at these graphs here, we can see with Amazon that that's continuing to spike upwards. Look at A&I Pharmaceutical, you can see a few dips over here, a spike and then another dip. AstraZeneca, Max. So this again is Max. So it's from 2012, this one, all the way up to now. So you can see that the graph is improving over time. iShares Global Clean Energy, you can see again, there is a steady line in the right direction, but you do get dips and troughs. Robinhood has continued to decline, so we shall keep a watch on that and what happens. Tesla has continued to grow, and then again, Vanguard S&P, you get peaks and troughs all the time. So again, it's heading in the right direction, but I'm not worried. So let's just ban this onto a spreadsheet quickly. So if I look at October, I can see that I had £376.98 in trading 212. However, in the month, I've actually added in £256.80 for the Vanguard S&P. And you can see here that I actually bought 67.24 of Peloton Interactive. I actually sold all of Peloton Interactive in the month. I purchased £103.04 of Robinhood, £56.19 of A&I Pharmaceuticals, £15.15 of iShares, and £35.13 of Amazon. So all in all, total purchases in November were, just add these in here, a change of £461.89. So let's see what that leaves us with in November. So 838.87. So that's actually going to be a loss of £47.37. So not brilliant, but I'm okay with it. And if we go back to Vanguard, then we can see here that we actually added in £600 worth of additional investments, and we actually made a personal investment loss of £12.53. Now, as you all know, I also rent out a property. So again, on the property, the total rent is $550 and the mortgage $180. So that again is a net profit of £370 there. So total profit in the month of November is £310 and 10 that you can see here. So still not a bad month. So if you've made it to the end of the video, then thank you so much for watching all the way through. If you like the video, then give the video a thumbs up, consider subscribing as always, and I shall see you on the next video.